Hello friends, welcome back to Topper's World. In this video, I'm going to share my views regarding how to write Band 8 essay in IELTS, both in academic and journal. I believe that those who are capable of writing 8 band essay, they can easily write task 1 like report writing or letter. So in this video, I'm totally focusing on writing task 2. There are a number of things that decide whether you are going to get 8 band or not. The things like the kind of vocabulary you use, the essay structure itself, linking devices, and of course, the variety of sentences and accuracy. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how you can add variety of your essay writing. How can you make different kind of sentences so you can get your dreamed score like 7.5 or 8 band in IELTS writing. So let's see what should we do or what kind of sentences we should we add to get maximum score. Suppose you have good ideas, brilliant ideas, okay, and your organization structure is good, and then you have added rich vocabulary, means suitable words, very important and high level words you added, and after that your sentences are simple. You write only simple sentences. You can never get 7 even. Your score will be around 6 band. Such is the effect of a variety of sentences in any IELTS writing. So how can we add variety, or what different kind of sentences should we write? Let's see. So first of all, let me tell you various types of sentences that you can add. First is simple sentence. Simple sentence means subject, verb and object. These three words combination. After that, you can add compound sentence, means you can add two simple sentences together and make one compound sentence. Then the third is, that is very important, is complex sentences. Means you should write some sentences in which you write subordinate clause, principal clause, and your sentences should have word like, linking word like although, though, yet, therefore, because, since, for, etc. And after that, you should also write some passive voices. Passive voice really very important in formal writing, and you have to add passive voices. Then conditional sentences, if your essay demands, then one question sentence that adds a taste to your writing. So let's see step by step what these sentences are. The first is simple. I'm writing simple sentences. Mostly students write a lot of simple sentences in their writing. They already know how to do this. And what they have to do is subject, verb, object combination. And this combination will make simple sentence like, for example, government should help the poor people, or you can say government provides free education to poor people. This is simple sentence. We can add more varieties. This is one more example. Government is subject, provides verb plus first form plus s, then free education to poor people. This is the predicate of the sentence. This is subject and predicate and object part. So in this way you can write simple sentences, and you already know how to write, and you add variety of simple, write a lot of simple sentences. But if you totally write simple sentences and do not use other form of sentences, then your score will not be more than 5.5 bands. So now we have to look for other type of sentences. In compound sentences, what do you do? You add two simple sentences combined together with conjunction like and. So and helps to, you know, combine two sentences, and, but, either, or, in this way. The example can be like this. Now look here. Sometimes we play football and sometimes we play cricket. They are two simple sentences. Both are simple and they are added or combined together with the conjunction and, with the help of conjunction and. So another sentence like, either you can go to Amritsar or you can go to Shimla. So this is another example of compound sentence. So you are supposed to write 4 to 5 compound sentences if possible in any essay in order to get good score. Next is complex sentences, and they are really very important. You need to write 5 to 6 complex sentences if you want to get 8 band. And complex sentences are those sentences where there is one principal clause plus subordinate clause, means one independent and one dependent clause. So in order to write such kind of sentences, you need to know about the words like although, though, yet, because. These are the linking words which help you to write complex sentences: while, therefore, so that, etc. Now look at both sentences. In the first, although he is poor, yet he is honest. Although he is poor, yet he is honest. This is a contrast. So although and yet have been used to show that contrast. This is a complex sentence. Sachin is the player who has scored highest runs in cricket. So this is another example. Many examples can be there, like although government is working hard to provide jobs to the poor people, yet it is not successful. There are many other examples, like for example, he did not work hard, therefore he could not get desired score. Next is passive voice. They are very important. Passive voice are used when action is important. Action is important, and doer is not important. When we highlight the action, not the doer, at that time passive voice are used. And secondly, passive voice are also used to explain the process and also to write general sentences. So they are very important. If anybody doesn't know how to write passive voice, it means that he is not familiar with 50% of English language. So he doesn't deserve even 6 band if one does not use passive voice in IELTS writing. So let's see how the passive voice are made. Normally, we know that subject, verb and object, this is called active. They are tense, we can say. And if we add helping verb, subject, this subject is actually object. Object turned subject. Then we have to add helping verb plus third form. Then after that, by, preposition by, and then subject turned object. So this is mostly optional. We need not to write, and we need to write this thing: subject, helping verb, and third form. Then it becomes passive voice. Let's see example. Now first see, money is deposited in the banks. Food should be kept covered. Old cars are sold here. Old cars are sold here. Are plus third form. So this is passive. Books are kept in Almira. This is another example of passive voice. You can also make compound sentences by combining two passive voice sentences. Question sentences are also very important, and you need to write one question sentence compulsory. One question sentence, and that should be in introduction. Should be added in introduction and nowhere else. Not in conclusion or in body paragraph, only in introduction. The first example is this: is it possible to eradicate crime from this world? Is it possible to finish crime or eradicate crime from this world. So this kind of line can be added into introduction. For suppose you get a topic related to crime, like how to finish the crime from this world, or despite of the best efforts of government agencies, crime is not finished. Do you agree or disagree? So you will write the opening line, and after that, in between, you can add this sentence like, is it possible to eradicate crime from this world? No, it is not. Or yes, it can be. So in this way, if you add such a phrase over there, this will give a beautiful taste to your essay, and you are surely get good impression on your examiner. Conditional sentences are those which are based on certain conditions, like they start with if or unless. If you work hard, you will succeed. For example, if you work hard, you will succeed. If you work hard. If you work hard, this is present indefinite. You work hard, you will succeed. So this is future indefinite. So this is a combination of present indefinite and future indefinite, and it is a conditional sentence. So conditional sentences can be like more examples, like if government creates more jobs, then people will not migrate to other countries. So in this way, you can add conditional sentences in your essay writing. Now, I suppose that if you have written good structure of essay and good variety of sentences, you are surely on the path of getting 7.5 or 8 bands. Condition is that your ideas are properly structured, you have written introduction very well, and added a rich variety or high level variety of vocabulary to your sentences, sorry, to your essay. So in this way, you will get high score. Thank you very much. I hope that you will like this video. If you like, then comment it and also share it with your near and dear ones. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.